see each other again, Lizzie, you know.
I know. Just being a bit of a sook.
Look, here's a couple of numbers I think you should have. One's for the Senior Citizens Community Centre, and the other one's for Myra Desmond, you know, from the Prison Reform Group. Now, you ring her if you need anything.
Well, I propose that we put in a final demand to have the new security measures removed. Now, if this is not met, I'm afraid we shall have to reluctantly strike.
Seconded.
All those in favour?
Well, if it isn't Queen Bee. Come back to take over the hive, have you?
You better believe it.
You heard Mrs. Powell, Smith. No talking.
Don't worry, Mr. Fletcher. There are some people I wouldn't bother talking to. Mouse, keep it down. The screws will be on to you.
Shh. Not a sound. Oh, quiet as a mouse.
It's not nice to stare, but what's the matter? Have I grown another head or something? If you had, it would be an improvement on the one you had before. I suppose you're responsible for the conditioned mouse, is he?
You mean her fit of the giggles?
No, she's always had a great sense of humour, haven't you, mouse? She is as high as a kite. Whatever she's taken, I'll bet you brought it in here. Yeah. Well, that's none of your business anyway. Well, I'm making it my business. Fair enough. Why don't you tell the screws then? Go on, lag at me in front of all the women. No, I don't operate like that. And you know it. You don't operate anyway, Smith. I'm top dog here now. And that's how the women want it. Sandy might even have fought for you, old crook. But she sort of let it slip through her fingers. It's lucky I was around to take up the reins. I owed you one from the last time I saw you in Barnhurst. Now, I owe you two.
What are you doing?
Just changing tables, Mrs. Powell. My food was starting to go off.
Well, look at that. Queen Bee just buzzed off.
I've spoken to the union office and they've agreed to support us. They promise statewide action if it isn't resolved soon.
Well, that's official then. What is this clause about skeleton staff?
Well, the members realise how difficult it will be for the senior staff to cope alone, so we're prepared to allow two union members per shift to assist. We'd prefer not to call in the police at this moment to man the prison.
Well, neither would I. Was that your idea?
Well, yes. I do feel that the women have seen enough of police uniforms in here for a while.
It's going to be very hard on them.
No harder than the current restrictions. And this action is for the women as well as for the officers.
Come in.
Be Smith, Mrs. Davidson. She doesn't want to be sent to the infirmary.
Well, I can't discuss it right now.
Oh, look, I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson, but I'm jack of lying around on my back all day with nothing to do. I need something to occupy me. I thought we could talk about it.
Not now, Smith. I have something important to discuss with Mrs. Morris.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris. I didn't mean to interrupt, but look, there's plenty of light work I could do. Couldn't I just go down to the...
Oh, all right, Smith. I'll think about it. Now, wait outside for Mrs. Powell.
Thank you, Mrs. Davidson.
Close the door, Mrs. Powell. Has there been any sign of trouble?
She had a bit of a confrontation with Winter, but back down. I don't think she's in any condition to cause trouble at the moment.
All right, take her to the laundry, but she is not to work the press. Mrs. Powell, I'm afraid I will have to ask you to work back this evening. The officers are going on strike as from 3 o'clock this afternoon.
Right.
It can be averted, of course, if the department meets our demands.
Well, you know them as well as I do. I don't think there's much chance of that, do you?
Oh, that's a good drop. Can't beat a good drop of scotch to warm the cockles of your heart, can you?
No.
I haven't had a good drop of scotch since I was out. Out Long Reach way. Oh, there's some nice pubs out there.
Yes, I've heard.
Excuse me.
G'day, love.
G'day.
You mind if I sit down?
If you like.
My name's Lizzie. What's yours?
Errol.
Errol? Just like Errol Flynn? Cool. There was a hunk of a bloke if ever there was one.
Yeah? I never saw him.
Oh, you don't know what you missed. Oh, you're not going already, are you? I haven't even bought you a drink. Hey, Ernie, fetch me another scotch and get something here for Errol and put down me slate.
Right, Mrs. Birdsworth. That's very kind of you.
Oh, seeing we're drinking in the same bar, we might as well have a chat, eh?
Well, I'm sure there is room for negotiation, Mr. Douglas. Yes, certainly, I'll tell her. Fine. Goodbye. Well, he wasn't very pleased about that.
What did he say?
He's coming over as soon as possible to talk things over.
But there's nothing to talk about unless he's prepared to relax security.
Well, there must be room for compromise, surely.
It depends.
If they are willing to negotiate, surely it isn't necessary for the officers to walk out.
The department's notoriously slow on making decisions on important issues. Having no staff may just speed them up.
But it is so disruptive.
A strike isn't meant to be convenient.
Judy Bryant is back. Her case comes up for hearing before the parole board next week, and they want a pre-hearing report. What am I supposed to do about that?
Do you want me to prepare it?
Well, yes, but I suppose it's obviously out of the question now.
I'll see what I can do. We don't want the women to suffer because of the strike.
Thank you, Meg.
Look, it's nearly 3 o'clock. Do you want us to return the women to their cells?
Yes, could you arrange it?
Back in your cell,
Brian. Well, be it ever so humble.
Come on, get a move on. How come you let this out early? Is it a public holiday or something? Oh, look who's here. How was the artist?
Still there.
There'll be no talking, just straight back to cells.
Hey, June. Hi, love. How are you? You look fantastic.
What's
all this back to cells?
Oh, you know, this joint with a laugh and hear anything.
Yeah, how's Lizzie?
She's been acquitted. She's out in the big wide world.
That's fantastic. We were very worried about her when we heard about it in Barnhurst. Listen, we got so much to talk about. How was your operation?
Oh, come on, Brian, shut up, will you?
Listen, I'm glad to be able to talk to you. Buddy Mary's taking over from Sandy, and she's filling this place full of dope. I need someone to help me get her off the throne.
Oh, honey, I'd love to help you, but the reason I'm back here is because my parole's coming up in a couple of weeks. I can't do anything to bugger that up.
Oh, bloody marvellous.
Listen, mate, surely you can either confirm or deny the report about the strike.
Try sign language, you might get through to it.
Here comes someone now.
Meg! What is all this about?
At the strike, you mean?
Yes, of course I mean the strike. Why on earth do you want to go and stir up trouble as soon as you become union rep?
Colleen, I don't expect you to understand. But there's more to this job than the paycheck at the end of the week. Now, I made my position quite clear when I stood for union rep, and I have the support of the other officers.
And I suppose you leaked the news to the press?
Yes.
Listen, as a prison officer, you are not authorized to give statements concerning the prison.
No. But as a citizen, I have the right to speak about matters of public concern.
And it's not going to do the union nor the department any good.
Well, quite frankly, I don't care. If this strike helps to regain the right to treat the prisoners as humans, then I've succeeded in what I set out to do.
Can you give us any statement about the strike?
Are the officers after a flow-on from the wage increase?
I'm Mrs. Morris, the representative of the officers' union. This is not a strike about wages. We are solely concerned about the conditions inside the prison. Now, I wish to make the officers' demands quite clear, so I would appreciate it if you would report me accurately.
Fire away, Mrs. Morris.
Look, Mrs., I can't sit here drinking your shouts all the time.
Rubbish. Set us up again, will you, Annie?
It's not that I wouldn't shout you, it's just that, well, I'm a bit broke at the moment. See, I had to pay the doctor for me brother.
The one you told me about. The nutcase.
Oh, he's not a nutcase. He's just a bit simple. He had a bit of an accident, see, and, well, the old man couldn't pay the doctor's bills.
Is he out of work?
Yeah. And he likes a drink. Or three.
Don't we all?
Will this go on your account, Mrs. Birdsworth?
Yes, love. Room 17.
It's not that the old man doesn't want to work. He just has a few too many in the pub at lunchtime, and then he forgets where he's working.
I've done that once or twice myself.
It's a real pity about me brother's accident, though. Taking all me cash like that. Just when Mum's birthday's coming up, too.
You can't afford to buy her a present.
No. Oh, but I'll get her something, I'll tell you that much. Right, just between you and me, I reckon there's a lot of easy money just waiting to be picked up. You look at Ernie's cash till over there. There must be hundreds in it. And I'd do it, too, for Mum. Well, she's worth it.
Don't you talk like that. You'll only end up in the slammer. Then you'd only see your poor old mum once every visiting day.
Well, what the hell am I supposed to do? I can't find any work.
Listen, Errol, you're a good young bloke. Any woman would be proud to have you for a son. You've been real good to me, helping me while away a lonely afternoon. I want you to do something for me. I want you to go out and to buy something real nice. Something that your mum would really love to have.
Hey? Now, I can't do that.
Of course you can, and you will.
Jeez. Lady, you're a real mate.
This is grossly unprofessional, Mrs. Morris. We're used to this sort of thing from the prisoners, but we do expect loyalty from our officers.
The officers are loyal to common sense and their own safety, Mr. Douglas. The riot showed just how effective the department was when it comes to backing prisoners into the corner. Now, all the staff want is a return to the old form of security. Now, there have been minor infringements.
Government departments are run to a system. Decisions are made by persons in authority, not by employees. I'm surprised you let it come to this, Mrs. Davidson.
There was very little I could do about it, Mr. Douglas. I have maintained the department's policy as far as I can, but when it comes down to it, I am inclined to share the officer's decision.
Very well. I'll see the minister about this, then I'll get back to you.
What do you want?
How long are we going to get locked up in here?
Until you let out.
What's going on? Are the screws on strike or what?
That's none of your business.
Pigs, it ain't. We're supposed to get fed, you know.
You will be fed when the food's brought to you.
And when's that going to be?
When there's staff here to serve it.
So the screws are out then.
Mrs. Morris, I didn't expect to see you this afternoon.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson's asked me to prepare a report for your parole board meeting.
Oh, that's terrific. But I thought the officers were on strike.
Well, this isn't officially prison officers' duties anyway.
Thanks, Mrs. Morris. I really appreciate it.
Now, despite your early record of escapes, the various reports put through to the classification committee have shown that over the past few months you've settled down a great deal, and this is why they're prepared to review your case. Of course, you do realise that if you get into any trouble at all between now and then, you won't stand a chance of being paroled.
Don't worry about me. I'm not going to rock the boat.
Good. Well, the first thing we have to prove is that you've got suitable accommodation and a job to support yourself.
Oh. Well, I don't have enough money to get a flat. The only job I've ever done is taxi driving, and I don't know if I'll be able to get my certificate back.
Well, I'll check that out for you. In the meantime, you try and think if you know anybody that could give you suitable accommodation, because we have to give an address to the board.
All right. And thanks very much, Mrs. Morris. I appreciate it. Hey, how long's that strike going to go on for?
Well, I can't discuss that with you, Judy. Anyway, why should you worry? Gives me plenty of time to check out that cab driver's license for you.
Them. What
right do they have to go out on strike? They're public employees.
Yeah, well, so are train and bus drivers, and they seem to get away with it. Anyway, I wouldn't complain too much. They're probably jacking up against the tight security restrictions.
Why should they do that?
They don't like it any more than we do. It just makes more work for them. And they know we don't like it. And they don't want another riot on their hands.
Yes, I suppose you're right. You have a pretty good understanding of people in here. I suppose you developed that over the years. Funny, you know, I never thought I'd end up in a place like this. Shouldn't think anybody ever does. You get the impression of a criminal being some sort of subhuman class. Really quite a relief to find an ordinary, normal person.
Well, hallelujah, the doctor's seen the light.
I didn't mean any offence.
Oh, built-up goody-two-shoes.
Oh, what have I said?
Skip it.
Toby, tell me. Look, I thought we'd become friends since I diagnosed your complaint.
Oh, yeah. All right. So I'm grateful. But don't go expecting any undying devotion.
What's wrong? Oh, I see. Oh, yes. The great B. Smith can't bear the thought of being in anyone's debt. That's right, isn't it?
Oh, don't talk garbage. Look, I just don't understand your angle. What's in it for you? All this little Miss Innocent sweetness and light floating down the corridors. It just doesn't ring true.
Why won't you trust me? What do you think I am, a spy or something?
Ah, now that's just it. I don't know what you are.
I'm sorry. Nobody else feels that way.
Oh, yes, they do.
Who else? Well, tell me, what am I supposed to have done?
I've just heard a little whisper here and there. Nothing much yet. But I'll wait until I find out more. And when I do, you'll be the first to hear about it.
Birdsworth.
Why? What's the matter?
Why don't you go back to your room and lie down?
Oh, yeah. Good idea.
Mrs. Birdsworth, come on. Give me a hand.
Yeah. Why not?
Up there, come on.
Let's dance. There's nice music. Get him to play the Guy Gordons.
Yeah, right.
Send up a bottle of grog to my room and charge it.
Oh, no, take it easy.
Get him to play the Shearer's Fancy, boys.
That's right, Birdsworth. Time for Betty Buys,
oh,
eh?
Oh, have you know I'm a respectable lady.
There we are. That's
right. I reckon I had a few too many, don't you?
Yeah, around about 20. There we are.
Oh, God.
Sleep it off now, eh?
Oh, lights out. Good night, Bee. Good night, Doe. Oh.
Oh, Mrs. Morris, how come you're working?
Well, the union's agreed to allow two members per shift to help out. I got the first shift. Hey, aren't you hungry?
No, I'm too excited to eat.
I phoned the Transport Regulation Board this afternoon, and they've agreed to reissue your taxi driving permit.
Hey, that's great!
Provided it's approved by the parole board.
Oh. Well, what do I have to do to get their approval?
Well, you have to have a job.
Now, isn't that wonderful?
To get a job, I have to have a taxi certificate, for which I will need a parole certificate, for which I will need a job. I mean, I'll be too old to drive the bloody taxi by the time it comes through.
Come on, Judy, don't get too upset. I know someone on the parole board, and I'm sure there's a way around it. The most important thing is that you find suitable accommodation. Now, have you got any ideas?
Oh, well, see, I've lost contact with most of my friends since I've been in here.
Well, isn't there anyone you could ask?
Well, I was pretty close to Pauline, my friend, but I haven't seen her in ages.
Well, I think you should try her. I mean, if you were that close.
We were very close. See, she's married now. I don't think her husband likes me very much.
Look, I think you should try her. We'll explain the situation. I mean, it's surprising how your friends rally when they know that you need them. Besides, she can only say no.
All right. I'll give you her address. It's... Thanks very much. You've been fantastic, especially with the strike and everything.
All part of the service.
Your mail, Bryant.
Oh, it's from Laurie.
Weren't you supposed to be collecting the dirty plates from this girl, Mrs.
Yes, I was just speaking to Judy about her parole.
It'll be on the call of duty, isn't it?
I do have an interest in prisoner welfare, Mrs. Powell. Judy, I'll come back to see you when I've spoken to Pauline.
Yeah, okay, thanks.
Was that necessary?
What?
Comments like that in front of the prisoners.
Meg, if you're on strike, you're on strike. So I don't see the point, and you're going out of your way to find extracurricular activities. Steve's arrived to relieve your shift, but Mrs. Davidson wants to see you before you go.
Certainly. I'll just take these to the kitchen.
Yes, thank you.
Mrs. Morris? Listen, what date is my parole hearing?
The 14th. Why?
Laurie's getting married on the 16th. She wants me to be there, and I reckon I can make it to Queensland then.
Yes, you could, but don't count your chickens. Anything could happen.
Well, you said yourself there's always a way around things. You know something? I wrote to her, and I said, just forget about me. But no, she went right ahead and told her fiancé all about me. And he's been fantastic.
Oh, don't you raise your hopes too high.
Oh.
Just what right has Mrs. Morris got to publicly criticize departmental policy? I've always thought of her as responsible, but that...
She is only stating the union's demand. She is the elected representative.
And talking of elections, it isn't too soon before the state elections. That's why the minister's up in arms about this.
I do not condone Mrs. Morris's actions any more than you do, but I will not have the prisoners in my care used as a political shuttlecock.
Erica, you are an employee of the department just as much as I am. We are both obliged to follow ministerial policy.
Very well. I am prepared to do that. But I would prefer to discuss this with Mrs. Morris myself.
Why?
Because I don't want the situation aggravated by things said in the heat of the moment. Well?
Oh, all right, I'll leave it to you.
Come in.
What's wrong with him?
That.
I see.
Meg, I do wish you had done things properly and gone through the correct channels. You know how the department feels about unauthorized press statements.
Yes, and now they know what we think of running a prison like the Spanish Inquisition.
Nevertheless, they decide the policy.
Yes, from a city office block miles away from the women. Oh, come on, Erica. You believe in a lighter approach to imprisonment the same as we do.
Maybe, but my hands are tied by the department.
That's always your excuse.
It is not an excuse. It is a reason. You seem determined to make something out of being union representative.
It's nonsense.
Is it? I don't think it is. Ever since you vied with Colleen Powell for the promotion, you have been intent on fighting the system.
Rubbish! Of course I was disappointed when Colleen was promoted over me, but it hasn't affected my attitude in the least.
Hasn't it? Well, I think it has. In my position as governor, it is my job to keep an eye on the attitude of the staff.
Very well. I had hoped that we could use our friendship to work this dispute out rationally. But as you point out, you're the governor and I'm the union stirrer. Perhaps if you'd got to your position by patrolling corridors and breaking up catfights for years, you'd have my attitude too. Obviously, having a university degree gives you a greater insight into other people.
Meg.
I don't think there's anything more to say at this stage, do you?
How's it going?
Oh, wonderful. Keep on like this, we could be on strike until Christmas.
That good, eh?
That good.
Meg, do we get normal night shift rates while we're on strike?
Is money all you think about?
Oh, no. Occasionally I think about women, but mainly money.
Believe it or not, there's more to this job than that. Now, if you don't take an interest in it, you'll get bored and then you'll do it badly.
I do take interest. 10% from the building society.
It's all it means to you, isn't it? A joke. Lots of funny women locked away from their families and friends because they made a mistake or did something the society didn't approve of. Ha, ha, ha.
Hey, no, I didn't
mean... Now, the answer to your question is yes. You will get night shift rates for a normal working week. Good night.
Yes, well, thank you for calling, Mr. Fletcher, but there's no need for you to come in. It looks as though this strike could go on for some time and you may have to work all through tomorrow night, so I suggest you get a good night's rest. Yes, of course. Goodbye. Come in.
Everything all right, Mrs. Davidson?
Yes, Mrs. Powell is taking the east wing, so I suggest you patrol blocks G, H and Solitary.
All right. Are you leaving now?
Yes, I certainly am. I'll be at home if you want to contact me.
Okay. Good night, Mrs. Davidson.
Good night.
I take it the strike's going ahead?
Yeah, it looks like it. The department won't back down in a hurry.
Oh, neither they should. There's no point in treating those bitches with kid gloves.
I take it you didn't vote for the strike, then?
Well, I had to go with the majority, didn't I? Anyway, why are we talking about work? We're about to have a lovely candlelit dinner.
I'll drink to that.
Come on in if you're good looking.
I thought you were still asleep.
Oh, it's you. No, nobody could sleep in here with only one threadbare blanket. The place is like a bloody fridge.
It's not supposed to have all the comforts of home.
No. But some of them wouldn't hurt. Like a nice warm body to cuddle up to. Anyone ever tell you you're nice? Any other screws on duty with you?
No. Mrs. Powell's over in D Block.
This is my last night here. Better make the most of it.
Gonna have to go in a minute.
All right. I know you can't stand my company. You're very quiet.
Janet, I do enjoy your company. But I think you're getting things a bit out of perspective.
How do you mean?
Well, as long as we enjoy being with each other and we're friends, it doesn't have to lead on to anything more serious.
Are you trying to tell me that you don't want us to see each other anymore?
No, no, of course not. I'm just saying that I don't want to be tied down to one relationship.
There's someone else?
No, there's not.
You think I'm trying to smother you? Now, you are just trying to squirm out of this.
No, look, that'd be ridiculous. Hell, I can't even talk sanely to you.
You can't even talk at all.
Would you just calm down a bit?
Now, just because I care for someone and cook for them and sleep with them doesn't mean that I want to marry them.
All right. What if I told you that I couldn't take you out next week because I was going out with somebody else?
I knew it. There is someone else.
No, there's not. It might as well be the way you're going on.
I just don't understand why you want to end the relationship unless there is someone else.
I don't want to end it. I just want to cool it a bit, that's all.
Yeah, and what are you going to do when your new lady friend starts coming on strong?
I give up. Thanks for the meal. When you want to talk sensibly, just give me a ring, okay?
Jim? Jim!
Fletcher.
Jim, it's me. Jim, I just want to say that it doesn't bother me if you want to go out with other women. I just want to be told about it, that's all. I don't want to be left out. I want to be part of your life.
I think we should let it rest for tonight, Janet. I'll see you in the morning.
All right. Provided you can get away from your precious job. And that'll give you another excuse to avoid me, won't it, darling?
Good night, Janet. Yes.
Jim, please.
Good night, Janet.
B, are you asleep?
Yeah. At least I'd like to be.
I can't sleep. I've been thinking about what you said.
Don't bother about it. I never do.
Who have you been talking to? What have they said about me?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Yes, I would. Look, I've been as honest as I can be with people in here, but, well, if somebody's spreading lies about...
No one here.
What?
I said... There's no one in here.
Who, then? The hospital?
Ah. Right in one. I spoke to a friend of yours. Well, no. No more an acquaintance than a friend, I'd say. A Dr. Gibson. Ralph Gibson, I think it was. Ring a bell? Yeah, he spoke very highly of your boyfriend. Ah, oh, well. Sweet dreams.
Jim!
Warmer now?
Uh-huh.
Got somewhere you can hide these?
Oh, you.
Gee, times are hard for a working girl.
I was worth at least a carton in the old days. Hadn't you better get back before you missed?
No rush. Mrs. Powell's the only other officer on duty. I'm not likely to run into her often.
Pity you officers don't go on strike more often. You know, for a screw, you're not too bad. Why do you do it?
Need the money.
No, I mean, why do you spend time with me? Like me, do you?
You're all right.
I'd have to be more than all right for you to take the risk. If the governor found out, she'd have your guts.
Yeah, well, let's hope she doesn't find out.
Yeah.
Look, I better get going. I'll come and let you out in the morning.
Okay.
Hello, Miss Conway. You're just in time. The usual, is it?
No, thank you, Paul. I was looking for Mr. Fletcher. Have you seen him, please?
No, I haven't seen him all night.
All right, thank you.
Who's there?
Yeah, it's me, Meg, Jim.
And I don't tell me you've come to persuade me to forget the strike.
No, I won't even mention work. Strictly personal. The fact is, I need a favour.
What?
A bed for the night.
You better come in.
Oh, I was just about to go to bed. It's been rather a tiring day. Now, what happened? Lock yourself out of your flat?
Well, yes, as a matter of fact, deliberately. I'm trying to avoid someone.
Oh, dear.
She's making me feel claustrophobic, Meg. I just can't seem to get away from her. When I brought it up tonight, she flew off the handle. She immediately assumed that there was somebody else. I can't seem to make her see that we can still be just friends. So I ended up storming out, and then she started plaguing me at home with phone calls.
So you jumped in your car and came over to see good old reliable Meg?
Yes.
Well, as I said before, Jim, I just don't want to get involved. I like Janet, and I can understand your feelings. But I don't want to take sides.
No, I'm not asking you to. Really, all I want's a bed for the night. Janet needn't even know. I'll sort it out with her in the morning. I promise.
All right. The bed in the spare room's made up.
Thanks, Meg. I really appreciate it. I just don't know what I'm going to do about her. I really
like
Janet.
Jim, I really am awfully tired. I was just about to go to bed.
Yes, sorry. Thanks again, Meg.
Well, you help yourself to anything in the kitchen, okay?
So.
Good night.
Night.
Hello?
Meg? It's Erica Davidson.
Oh, good morning.
I want to apologize about our discussion last night. I didn't intend it to go so far.
No, neither did I.
I thought about it overnight, and you're quite right. I have been allowing the department, and Ted Douglas in particular, to dictate to me.
Well, I didn't mean it to sound that way.
I know. The point is, I'm prepared to back the officer's stand. I wondered if you could come in and discuss it, and we could approach the department together.
Oh, yes, I'd be glad to. Well, I'll be there as soon as I can. Guess what? Eric is going to back the union. We're going to confront Douglas this morning.
Good. The sooner everyone's back to work, the better.
Well, hold on. The strike's not over yet. Got to see what the department says first. Oh, yes, help yourself to breakfast. I'm sorry I can't get you any bacon and eggs, but I want to get to work straight away.
No worries. I'll just help myself to some coffee, then I'll pop home and change. I'm doing it at work later myself.
Well, I'll see you there then.
Yeah, Meg. Thanks again for last night.
That's all right. Actually, I should be the one thanking you. I haven't slept so soundly for ages, just knowing that there was a man in the house. Don't make a habit of it, though.
Oh, don't worry. I won't.
Bye.
See you later.
Morning, ladies.
Oh, come on. Break it up. You lot are supposed to be on strike. We can have a sleep in.
Well, that's a lovely welcome. Sandy, what are you doing here?
Oh, about 10 years, if I'm lucky. This is my cell too, remember? Have you taken in lodgers while I've been away?
I'll make us some coffee.
Oh, hey, Steve-o.
What was that, Edwards?
Sorry, Mr. Faulkner, sir. When's breakfast?
Got no idea.
Jeez, can't get the help these days, can you? Well, the prodigal returns. How's the hospital?
Oh, well, a lot better than this place. At least people didn't jump up and down on my bed.
Sorry. All right?
Yeah, I just don't want to get up yet.
Do you want a cup of coffee, Bee?
Oh, God's truth. Well, I might as well, mightn't I? I am obviously not going to get any rest.
Well, what's been happening?
As I told you, Mari took over and immediately they dragged you away.
Oh, well, that doesn't surprise me in the least. Had a funny feeling she set me up for the bunny all along.
Oh, do tell. What do you mean?
Well, she made it very clear that I was the leader of the riot. But she was the one who set the whole thing up, did all the arranging. Muggins here just stood by to take the rap. Oh, anyway, I'm out now. And we'll fix her. What do you reckon, B?
Bloody oath.
What will you do?
I don't know yet. You got any ideas?
Can't do anything until after the strike. Let's talk about it later.
How's the coffee coming?
Won't be long.
How'd you get on in solitary? Ah, oh, piece of cake. It's a cinch when you've got a way of passing the time.
So we go back to the old level of security?
Basically, yes, except the corridor gates have to be kept locked for the time being.
Well, even that creates problems.
I appreciate that, but it's a small compromise, surely.
Yes, all right. Now, what about the compulsory transfer of staff?
Well, the department seemed determined to stand firm on that, but I think Ted Douglas may back down now.
Why? What have you been up to?
I've been promoting solidarity within the union. I phoned an acquaintance who is a committee member with the Union of Public Servants and suggested the department may start imposing compulsory transfers on their members. He thought he should advise Mr. Douglas that the UPS is standing firm behind the prison officers' demands.
That was sneaky.
Oh, not really. I'm just fighting Ted Douglas with his own weapon, politics. Come in.
I transferred Edwards back to a cell, Mrs. Davidson.
Right. Now, has your relieving duty officer arrived?
Yes, Mrs. Barfield.
Good. Well, you can sign off. Go home and get some rest.
Well, the women are getting a bit restive about breakfast. Should I stay and help supervise distribution?
Yes, I think that will be all right. I don't think the union would object to one extra officer being on duty at this stage. Well, there's someone who doesn't seem to have been affected by the strike.
The only thing that affects him is the size of his pay packet.
Right. Well, now, I think we've attended to all the demands on your memo.
Yes, I think we have.
All that remains now is for me to contact Ted Douglas. Wish me luck. Yes, could I speak to Mr. Douglas, please? It's Erica Davidson here.
So I walk into the dining room, and there she sat with that slimy, sneaky smile of hers all over her face. Mouse was off the planet. God knows what she'd taken, but she was not well. The screws must have been blind not to pick it.
Who was on duty?
Oh, Perry and Powell. Anyway, I could see trouble was brewing. I thought if the screws came down on us, they'd soon see something was going on with Mouse. I didn't want to get her into trouble, so I kept my trap shut.
Yeah. Well, it's a good thing you did, too. I mean, picking a fight with Mari. She can handle herself pretty well.
Oh, I can look after myself, all right.
Sandy's right. You ought to let yourself recover from surgery.
Yeah. If you've got any tough stuff you want done, leave it to me, okay?
Fair enough. Think you can handle it?
Hey! I can look after myself. They make us tough in the Bronx.
I was glad to see Jude back. I thought I might get a bit of support from her, but she can't get mixed up in anything because her parole's due.
So, how does Mara get the stuff inside?
I haven't got a clue. But someone must know.
What about it, Kate?
What?
How does Mara get hold of that junk?
No idea.
Oh, yeah? I'll bet. You sure you didn't land a supply of pills while you were working in the examination room?
Certainly not.
But Kate's straight.
Yeah.
Do you know something I don't?
Just a little something I heard from one of the doctors at the hospital who knew her. And he wouldn't trust her as far as he could spit. I'm just biding my time till I find out more.
What's this all about?
She's got some sort of guilt complex. She feels indebted to me because I diagnosed her kidney failure. And she's looking for an excuse now to rid herself of the debt.
Well, thank you, Doc, but I think I'd prefer a second opinion.
Look, we've got enough problems without fighting amongst ourselves.
So who's fighting? I'm just saying that sooner or later we will find out a little more about our lady doctor, and then we'll see who's right. And I'm happy to wait.
Oh, yes, Ted, of course. I'm sure we can get them back on the job immediately. No, of course not. I'll leave the press statement to you. Fine. Goodbye. Well, we have a compromise.
Which is?
He agreed to what we discussed. Security within the prison is at my discretion, but he wants to maintain armed guards on the perimeter fence and bring in guard dogs.
Dogs? Whatever for?
Well, to make certain no one escapes. In any case, I don't see it affecting the relationship between the prisoners and the officers, so it shouldn't be a major obstacle.
I suppose not. Are we expected to look after them?
No, I understand a handler will be coming in for a couple of hours each day to feed and groom them.
Well, I don't suppose the officers will object, but I'll have to inform them at a meeting.
Well, of course. How soon do you think the officers will be back on duty?
Well, I'll phone around and get them in for a special meeting. And no doubt, we'll have the afternoon shift on as rostered.
Well, I'm glad we solved that problem and still remain friends.
¶¶ He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sure.